OncoMatrix Tool, Genomic Data Commons, GDC 2.0 Video Guides, Massey Frotan, GDC Scientific Support Analyst, Center for Translational Data Science, University of Chicago. In this video, we are going to introduce the OncoMatrix Tool. This tool provides a matrix plot of the first 2,000 cases with the most mutations and for the top 50 mutated genes affected by high-impact mutations. To get to this page, on the home page, click on Analysis Center on top left. Then, in the Analysis Tools section, click on the OncoMatrix Play button. To demonstrate the tool here, we are using a sample cohort that contains lung cancer patients who are 50 years or older. We have named this cohort Lung 50+. We have videos on creating and using cohorts. If not already seen those, we encourage you to watch them to see how cohorts are created. Note that when we set these criteria, the total number of cases and the cases showing individual mutations will be updated accordingly. So here in this page, after the cohort was set, you can see the number of, for example, TP53 has changed from 2000 to 786. And the total number of the cases from 2000 to 1193. So here, each row will stand for one gene, which are the ones that display mutations in the selected cohort. And if we hover the mouse over the columns, we can see the details about the cases in which the gene is mutated. The tooltip will show the case ID, the mutated gene ID, and details about the mutation type. So, we have 50 genes here, and we want to limit it to the top 10 genes for demonstration purposes. So we click on 50 genes, and second bottom row down here, we have maximum number of genes. We change it to, say, 10, and you see only the top 10 genes will show up. And you see that the number of cases will also be updated from 1193 to 1163. We will get to the rest of the options later. On the top center here, we have a zoom tool. You can use it to zoom in and out, and then using the scroll bar, you can navigate throughout the cases. And if you zoom in enough, the case IDs will appear at the bottom here. That may depend on your screen resolution, in this example about 7x. And you can also click on this reset to go back to the default view. So, back to the cases button. We have a few features here. The sort cases option, which you can set the grouping hierarchy based on whether or not the data contain copy number variation or CNV, or simple somatic mutation or SSM, or both. When the first option is selected, the cases are grouped into with and without SSM, as shown by SSM narrow flags grouped, and then grouping by having CNV or not will be nested inside SSM groups. When the second option is selected, the CNV grouping outside SSM will no longer be applied, as it can be seen in the right group on TP53G row here. It's important to remember that the grouping for different genes are not independent, and grouping for each gene is nested into the gene on the top row. For example, if you pay attention to this TTN gene here under TP53, you can see that these CNV-only samples are not grouped together, but they are grouped within the groups that are associated with TP53. The third option will sort the cases by ID, which can be seen when we zoom in enough to see the IDs at the bottom row. So let's zoom back. The maximum number case is self-explanatory. We'll set the top X number cases with mutations. With group case by, you can also cluster cases by other criteria of interest. For instance, we will select primary site. So we click on this plus sign, then go to project, and then select primary site. Here you can see the cases are grouped by the primary site because our original cohort was mostly lung cancer patients. So the majority of them are bronchus and lung. A few have primary site was colon, and some like 200 cases pancreas. On the gene tools, there are some options for gene labels, mostly for display preferences. For instance, you can change the count in front of the gene names into percentage or hide it at all. Variables contain some labeling tools to add extra labels to the cases. For example, here we group the cases by mutations again and add the same primary site we used for grouping before, this time for labeling. So we click Submit here, and the added label can be seen below the existing ones. The Cell Layout tool contains controls for customizing the appearance in terms of grid style, number of columns, etc. Same as the legend layout, but it is important to remember that we can customize the view directly on the legend too. So if we click on, for example, Miss Sense on the legends, we can both hide the flags on the cases and hide the case itself at all. And finally, download is for downloading a screenshot of the screen after you got a desired visualization as an image for documentation purposes. So this concludes the basic features of OncoMatrix Tool. For more guidance on this and other GDC data portal tools, please refer to the video tutorials or go to docs.gdc.cancer.gov.